Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you are well. Welcome to... Oh, there goes my microphone. That's a good start. No, my earpiece. That's a good start for the day, isn't it? As I yank it out of my jeans. How are we all doing? Greetings. Welcome to Suarez HQ. We are here and we're live. It's just gone 7:30 here in the UK. And we're going to do some hellos in just a short while and introduce you to Monochrome Week. So, without further ado, let's run some VT and I'll see you in 30 seconds. Right, so how are we all doing today? I hope we're all keeping well and healthy. That's the most important thing. We're going to do some shout-outs and some hellos in a very short while. Yes, so let's introduce you to what's going on behind me. And if I stand out of the way for a moment, you can see we've got a giant piece of canvas on the floor. It's 3.1 metres long, 150 centimetres wide. Don't ask me what that is in old money, no idea. But anyway, that notwithstanding, so this is what we're going to be painting on this evening, ladies and gentlemen. Now, don't be concerned about Monochrome Week. It means we're going to have some fun with some black and white. And you never know, we might just be throwing in a little bit of gold as well, because it wouldn't be a Suarez Week without a drop of gold, would it? Let's be honest. So that's what we're going to be attacking. I got it in my head exactly what we're going to do, so I'm going to show you quite an unusual and new technique this evening, something we haven't done before live on air. Great. Fabulous. So, without further ado, let us look online and see who we've got joining us this evening and where everybody is from. Do let us know, because my memory is terrible and I can never remember. So, we've got Damiana Herrera, we've got Megan Michael, Funny Fox is here. Hello, George and Caroline. And we've got Explode 1989 here. Elizabeth Kay is here. And James McCormack is here. Good evening to you. Gosh, those lights seem very bright this evening. And we've got Tina Lanning is here. I think she was first on this evening. And who else have we got? Richard Wills. Hi, guys. And who have I missed? Elizabeth Kay is here. Jeffrey Jenkins is here. Hello, good evening. I'm not sure. Jeffrey, have you been here before? If you haven't, welcome aboard. And we've got Lucy Blake is here. The Rita is here. Ian Holmes is here, Nikki J is here, and we've got Paul Ambler, and hi, how you doing, Paul? Nice to see you. Antonia Payan is here from Austin in Texas. Yeehaw! Is that the wrong area? I'm so sorry if it is. I'm not good with my geography. And Gala Petrova is here from the Ukraine. Good evening to you. And Henry the Artist 78 is here from Illinois. How are you doing? Nice to see you here, Henry. And Shannon is here, Francis is in here, Octane Music from Pensacola, Florida, good evening, hi, how are you doing? Deep Ashtray is here, Thomas Johnson is here, also from sunny Florida. We've actually had quite a sunny day here too, actually, probably not as good as yours. Okay, this is good, so what else have we got? Francis here, oh, Francis is in Belgium, excellent, great to see you. Now, I even think, ladies and gentlemen, if technology has worked as it should do, my mum might be watching tonight. So if you're there, hello mum and everyone who's watching. This is a great honour. I feel like so under pressure now. Anyway, and yes, thank you, James. He's mentioned AD for all of you who may or may not have been here before. We've got AD who's in the other side of the pod here, pressing all the controls and the levers and putting coal in the fires to make sure it all works. So I think we should give him a round of applause before we start. Give yourself a round of applause, dude. Okay, fantastic. Michelle Greenfield is here. Hello. Nikki says, how are you, AD? Hope you're well. Yes, he's very well. He's awesome, as usual. Right. Okay, ladies and gents, this is great. We'll have a periodic look back at your comments. As we go on, AD's going to feed them through into my ears as you start commenting as well. So if you've got something you want to know, anything you want to say, please do give us a shout. Remember, if you're new here, we've got four cameras, so we're just going to whiz through them now. So obviously we've got corner cam, hello corner cam. We've got the PTZ Zoom high def cam, hello PTZ, how you doing? We've got overhead cam, Izzy steps on the canvas, good evening overhead cam. Chest cam is good to go. Now chest cam is all about giving you a first person view about what things look like. So we'll be mixing paint, we'll be getting down and dirty on the canvas, all that kind of stuff. But hopefully this will give you a proper real world view. I'm really tempting my bin. Look at that, what a disgrace. And so we'll be flicking through all the cameras as we go on. And I think then I'm going to talk you through what we're going to do soon. Should we get going? Should we do some painting? One final hello, because I know people are joining us left, right and centre. This is cool. Who else have we got? Living Lucky 09. Question, when are you going to do a giveaway, Mr. Ed? Yes, good question. We have got a painting still to give away. And as we're getting close to 20,000 subscribers, we've got another painting to give away. So I think we'll get through Easter. Let's revisit it next week, okay? So we haven't forgotten, don't worry. Don't forget, if you're new here, do give us a thumbs up if you're liking what you've got so far. And remember to subscribe, hit the subscribe button, okay? And give us a follow on all the social media networks, because there is so much happening on a daily basis. I literally am going to explode because I can't remember it all. Okay, right, so Aidy's going to whiz out now and put the extractor on. And I am going to start work, okay? Let's go, right, okay, so I think you've probably got me on corner cam now, so you'll see me now over at the bench. As soon as Aidy's back in, he's going to probably go onto the chest cam. That's it, we've got the extractor on. Oh, thank goodness for that. I need it to get a bit cooler in here. I think it's about 80 degrees so far. Elizabeth Kay says hi to my mum. That's very nice. Oh, fantastic. Right, okay. Oh, and James Holmes is here from Denver, Colorado, who enjoyed last week's Q&A. Thank you very much, James. That's very kind of you. Okay, don't forget you can go and share this online now. Invite people to come and have a look at the craziness. So if you know anybody who think they might want to watch what we're doing here, excuse me, copy the link at the top of the page, send it to them, share it. Let's get the party started, shall we? Okay, right, so Aidy's back in the fold, which is fabulous. So we're on chest cam, good. So there we go. This is our big expanse of canvas. Now, I don't know how big or small it looks like on the cameras, but I can assure you, if you were stood here, you may very well find this size of canvas pretty intimidating. It is just a whisker over 3 meters long, and it's 1.5 meters wide. So when this is finished and stretched around its frame, it'll be 275 long centimeters by 130 wide, which is what I class as being a large painting. Okay, this is now going to start and get some of the paint on that I want to. And we are going to start, ladies and gentlemen, with some white paint. Now, what I'm also going to put in, I'm keeping the color palette very, very simple this evening. I love painting with white and black paint. You know, you can do such a lot with color, but certainly when you're creating, it really forces you to think about textures, light and dark, shapes, forms. Really does force you to think about how can I best show off these two extremes, and that's what I love about it. So Artfish42 has got a brilliant question. How do we keep the extractor so quiet? Well, you might like to know it's not rated at 98 decibels. So it is very, very loud in here. But the way we keep it so quiet is basically because I've got a non-directional microphone shoved into my face. So literally up there where you can see it, because it falls out most weeks. So that literally only collects all the audio under here. And of course, I wear ear defenders, as you can see. And that blocks out a lot of the noise. Otherwise, I literally can't hear anything. So I got Aidy in this ear. I mean, you imagine now, poor Aidy's outside, literally sat a foot away from the extractor, trying to concentrate on everything I'm saying, and he's got that in his ears. So it is loud. It does a very good job, don't get me wrong, but my goodness, is it loud. But hopefully, yes, because it's the microphone. The microphone only picks up what's localized into my mask. Okay, Dan Davis is here. Hey, do you make thumbnails before you start? Yes, Dan, I do thumbnails before I start. I always do those on Photoshop and post them out. Les Knights here. Hi Les, how you doing? Good to see you. Silver Star, you are the one. I don't know what that means. Okay, but hi, how you doing? Shashi Karai is here. Oh, this is great. Damiana loves the size of the canvas. Great. Right, let's get some paint on, shall we? Have we not got Zane Taylor here this evening? Where's Zane? A few familiar faces are probably off doing something else. Right. Okay. So if we can go on to corner cam and maybe overhead as well, please, buddy. Okay, fantastic. So now you can see on the screen, I'm going to give you the first lot of paint which is going to go on now. It might be a bit difficult to explain, so I'm going to try and do this the best way that I can. Now, about a year and a half ago, I painted a canvas, which for me was one of the greatest things I think I've ever done. I mean, we all have our own personal favourites and things that we really enjoy and like doing, but it really was one of my absolute favourites. And I think I painted it just in one of the new year 2018 or something, 2019, something like that. Anyway, that notwithstanding, it was called Newspaper Castles and it was a black, white and gold painting. Oh, Zane's here. Good evening, Zane. How are you doing? Oh, he's good morning from New Zealand, actually, isn't he? And anyway, so yeah, what I want to do is try and recreate some of the techniques from that particular painting. I did post that out on the social networks earlier on. And that's what I'm going to try and recreate this evening. Now, admittedly, that took around three sessions, around about six and a half hours to do. So I'm not sure if I'm going to complete it all this evening, but I'm going to give it a jolly good go, folks. Right, I'm just going to change the head on my scraper. So, let's have a look. So, actually, hopefully we'll be able to see, well, you certainly will be able to see once I get this moving around. Oh dear, that doesn't seem to fit, does it? Right, I think I've removed too much off the end. Right, let's resort that back out again. Sorry, folks. Don't disappear. Let's just stick that back on. Okay, so what we've got here on the we're on the overhead, aren't we, dude? Yeah. So we're on the overhead. So what I'm going to do, I need some small areas just of white. Now, the reason I'm not going to cover all of the canvas tonight is because I want to leave some of it empty, because the thinners will react slightly differently where there is no paint. And this is to help me try and get some of the effects that I'm looking for. Oh, Ady's just told me that it's 6:30 a.m. for Zane. Goodness me, you are keen. Thank you so much here. I don't know what the time is where everybody is, but That's pretty impressive, Zay, that you'll get up and watch us at 6:30 in the morning, so thank you for that. Really, really, yeah, I think you need a round of applause for that. Okay, so Zane's just got a round of applause, excellent. Okay, so what I'm doing now, as you can see on the chest cam, is I'm just manoeuvring this with my scraper. Now, for those of you who have seen the broadcasts before, it's one of my trusted tools in the arsenal of awesomeness. And these scrapers are brilliant because they help you cover a large surface area in a relatively short period of time. And they're surprisingly accurate at actually manoeuvring the paint into reasonably evenly distributed segments. So we're just going to literally... I'm doing some up and down movements now with this because this is very much an up and down kind of painting. So what I'm going to be doing here is starting to add some of the black in very shortly, and then you'll start to see what happens, and then you'll understand the reasons why I'm leaving some of this canvas blank. Okay, that's fine. So, Derek Van Dusen is here. Hello, good evening, Derek. Nice of you to join us. Who else is here that hasn't said hello yet? Ady will let me know in my ears through the miracle of technology. It's just while we finish spreading these out. So, Dirty, hello, good evening. Not sure if we've met before. Yeah, so you were expecting something small? No, we don't work on small stuff here. So, Dirty, we can't have any naughty words on the feed, by the way. otherwise we'll have to hide that one. So keep it all clean, ladies and gents. Thank you ever so much, because there's lots of youngsters viewing. You can say holy sheep doo-doo if you want, if that helps. But yes, folks, let's keep it all clean. Let's keep it all clean. Zachary Haar is here. Hello, good sir. How are you doing? Jay Prelli is here. Good evening. That's a new name. Hi, how you? Let's give you a wave. Which camera are we on, buddy? Hello, how you doing? Nice to see you, Jay Prelli. Right, okay, right. So, let's have a quick recap before we start getting the other colours out. Okay, so on the overhead you can see, these are the rough areas where I've gone down and up in a quite a random fashion just to get myself some lines. Now what we're going to do when we start applying the black, I'm going to get it into some what's the word I'm looking for? Cups. Yes, it wasn't difficult. Four letters. Some cups. And I'm going to start dropping in some lines. Now these lines are going to be fairly thin, because as they go on I'm going to start adding some thinners and a special sauce, which is what we use sometimes regularly here on the streams, and then we're going to start and watch all the colors start to blend into themselves. One interesting thing I'm going to add to this is some more white, so don't think I'm done with the white. This is just to allow a little bit of blending and a little bit of negative space, and I don't want all of the canvas just to be blank or bare underneath. Oh, Dirty, thank you very much for your comments. Yes, so thank you for sticking by the rules and for understanding. We appreciate that. And you're a watercolourist. Well, great. We've got another fellow artist here. Fantastic. Thank you very much for joining us this evening, Dirty, as well, by the way. And if you are new here, please do say hello if you're able to. That will be great. Right, as you can see here, I'm just decanting out some of the colours I'm going to be using now. I did say it's monochrome, so we are literally just blacks and whites. I've cheated a little bit and I got some cream. And I think we're definitely going to have to get some gold out, but we won't apply that just yet, because gold is gold finger. That's a really cool stuff to use, is the gold, so let's just get that ready. I can get rid of some of these because I don't need them. Now this is my gold. Actually, should we just open it? Yeah, for those of you who haven't seen the gold before, let's... Should we do it? Let's do it.
Do it! Just do it! Yesterday is set tomorrow. So just do it! Make your dreams come true! Nothing is impossible! No, what are you waiting for? Do it! Just do it! Yes, you can!
So, can we see that on the chest cam? Look at that. Whew. Sensational. So we're going to put some of that on as well. Okay, oh, Big Worm is here. Hi, Big Worm. And Simon Otterson is here from Sweden. Funny Fox says, bigger canvas is always more exciting. Yes, indeed. Haremo Santelaya Garcia is here. it's a difficult name, that. Hello, how you doing? Nice to see you. This is great. This is brilliant. So it's so good to hear us all here. Rasmus is here from Denmark. Good evening, everyone. Right. Okay, are we ready then? Let's start. So, let's get the black on first. Okay, that's one. So I've got to be fairly careful with where I place these. And what I'm going to do, I want to keep the lines fairly regular and fairly even. Okay, and then I'm going to be going from both directions. So where I've got my larger gaps, I'm going to do a couple of applications. Now this one's running into the white, so I'm just going to do a separate one there, and then move this one up slightly. And this is very much an up and down painting. It might not look it just yet, but trust me. Trust me, I'm a doctor. Okay, so let's do the same here. And then the hope is that they're going to start moving towards each other. Well, that's the general principle anyway. All right, that's quite white there, so I need to get another one there. There we go, that's nice. So we'll get a couple there. Now you might be thinking, wow, okay, what's that going to be then? But like I said, all will become clear, my friends. There we go. Right, so I've got one on the edge here. Nice. Right, so I'm not too concerned about how even or not this is distributed. The black is really going to start forming in quite some very intricate shapes very, very shortly. But before I do that, I want to get some cream on. So I think what's quite important with these is that I can, you know, add things to it. Just gives it some very subtle highlights. You know, this is all about, did you say corner cam, buddy? So this is all about the differences between light and dark. But then I also want to play with those kind of, almost like the grey areas. I'm going to have plenty of separation between black and white, but I also want to have a little bit of fun where they mix together. And cream's a really good sort of intermediary when you start to get greys, because it just adds a little bit of warmth. Last thing I want is for this to get too cold, so we're just going to warm it up a little bit, so to speak. Now again, I'm being fairly relaxed on where I put it, but I do want some of this black to blend with the cream. Okay, so I'm going to extend, not everywhere, but just a few of these out to where the black is. There we go, because this will all start to blend together very shortly. So 1, 2, 3, 4, that way I've got just one here. So I think that will do. We'll get one in there, and maybe one there. That'll do. That's cool. Okay, right, so technically three colours down. I think we'll get some gold in next. Oh, I'll tell you what, even with the extractor on, it's blooming warm in here. Right. Oh, hey. Ady's just talking to me. No, mate, you're absolutely fine. Can hear you loud and clear. Right, can we see that? Mmm. Oh, if you could be here right now. Oh, you are, aren't you? That's good. Okay. Right, just before I put the gold on then. Right, Katerina is here. Hello, Katerina. Yona Shearer is here. Hi, how you doing? Cream soda you're talking about. Okay, that's fine. Cream colour. Right, I'll let you carry on talking about cream while I get the gold on. Right, so let's see now. Now I think, let me just think a second. Let me think. Well, that was an intense moment, wasn't it? Right, okay. Let's get some gold on. I want this in... I don't want this spread everywhere. I just want this to be focal. Kelly Curry Shocker is here. You're late. Back of the class. Detention. That's it. That's it. You're banned. Sorry. Too late. Just kidding, of course. We wouldn't do that to anybody. You're all part of the family. I hope my mum's still watching. Okay, I'm just going to empty the last few droplets here. I want to still preserve some of this. It's all about the up and down. On the overhead cam, this is going to look like random up and downs, nothingness, but I'll just have a look on my laptop. But I promise you, this is going to get very interesting very, very quickly. Okay. Right, Michelle Greenfield, did I say hello already? Oh, you're here anyway. Okay, you're all having a chat, you're all happy, that's fine. Right, okay. The next thing, my lovely friends, what we're going to do is use this. Ta-ta-ta. This is thinners. Woohoo!
No, God! No, God, please, no! 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 No!
Well... For those of you who know, thinners is brilliant stuff because, well, it thins the paint, but it also helps us to move paint around because it helps dissolve one of the chemicals, creates a new reaction with the paint and forces it to flow like rivers. So this is where it's going to get really interesting now, folks. Now I have to be very... Oh, do you know what? No. Oh, you nearly got me. I just need to put the white on, of course. I need the rivers of white. I knew there was one I'd forgotten. It's me getting completely ahead of myself. Now, which camera, dude? Okay, so the whole reason for white, as these applications start to move and caress and mingle into one another, I don't want them to get too heavy. The white's then going to be the bridge between them, so this is going to mix with the black, it's going to mix with the gold. I'm going to get all kinds of wonderful, amazing tones. So I'm going to get this on now, and I'm going to be fairly liberal with this, especially where the black is concerned. Right, and I ran out, that's how much I'm using, so let's get some more on. Get some more on, you moron. Okay, right, let's go from the other side as well. Okay, so making sure I'm I'm dealing with some of this near the black. I'm also quite got to be fairly concerned that I don't miss all these giant open spaces. So Stanton, let her rip, tater chip. I like that. Maybe that should be on a t-shirt. By the way, we are producing a range of t-shirts at the moment. I don't know if you knew that or not. And some other merchandise like mugs, baseball caps, that kind of thing. Some really cool designs we're working on between us. So we'll keep you posted on that. But don't be surprised if we start giving them away during the live stream. Oh yeah, oh yeah. That's what we do here. We like giving stuff away, don't we? Okay, right, so fine. So just before I get the thinners on, I want to make absolutely sure I'm not missing anything. Okay, I think we're pretty good. So I'm going to do a mixture of two things now while I get the thinners on. I'm going to do some pouring, and I'm going to do some splats from high up. Oh, I don't have a technical terminology for it. So the ones I'm going to pour are going to be onto black, and the others are going to get dealt with from a great height. So there we go. Anyone like any ice in theirs? That's my thinners. Don't worry, Les, I'm not going to drink anything. Right, so I'm just thinking now, can I actually step on this? What do you think? Should I step on this or not? Should I? No? Yes? No?
No, God! No, God, please, no!
Right, okay, no. Yes, yes, yes! Do a step on it. Okay, right, let's see. Right, let's start with this black one here. Oh, that was a good one. Right, let's start with that. Let's go with this one. Right, I may not be doing much talky for a second. AD said good, thanks a lot. I'd like to say I'll be walking home. He'll be walking home, but he gave me a lift today. So if I upset him, I'm walking home.
Well, excuse me, princess.
Okay, right. So most of the black is treated at the moment. So I'm going to just see how that pans out. I've got a couple more to do, so let's get some thinners on there. Now this is where it's going to start to get interesting now. Right, let's get the gold done. End of that black one needs doing. End of that one needs doing. Let's hope I got the spacing of this right. That one. Oh, that's a good one. Oh yeah, get in. Right, and this one. Okay, now, got some slaps there. Right, let's keep going with that one. Now, interestingly here, where I haven't put anything on the canvas prior, there's, like I said at the outset, there's a different reaction going on the actual canvas itself. Now, I'm just trying to be quite mindful of where the black's going. Oh, that was a good one. That splashed all over the place. Sweet! Now I may have to get in with my hands if this doesn't start moving, so I have to react quite quickly to what's going on here, folks. The important thing is we get the thinners on. I'll go from there. Right, this is going to start moving now, which is exactly what I want. However, I might just start to have a little manoeuvre with my tools. Now then, do you know what I'm thinking? I might just change my tool. So let's see if I can get that off the end. I've got a feeling I'm not going to get that off. Ah, There's one I made earlier. Right, let's deal with that. Okay. Say hello to my little friend. Okay. I'm just going to ask, hey, do you think is it Corona time, mate? Do you think?
It's Corona time. Hey, it's Corona time right now. It's Corona time. It's Corona time.
Ah, right. Might as well keep it topical. Okay, right. So, let's have a look. Where do we need to push this now? So I'm going to start gently just teasing some of these into the shapes that I want before we add a little bit more of the thinners. Okay, because I need this to start to maneuver itself around. Now, see what's happening? Instantly now, where it's touching the white, I'm getting the greys, which is good. So I just need to tease it a little bit, help it on its way. And I want to still keep these movements going in an up and down direction. Now, a lot of these are going to sort themselves out with the drying process and the curing, which is great. I nearly knocked the light over. Okay, brilliant. So we'll have a look at some chat in just a moment. I'm going to just quickly change the end, the wormises. Let's bring a little bit of that into there. Bring that into there. Okay, you can see this on the overhead now. This is where we're starting to build our shapes up. Okay, that's pretty reasonable. Excuse me. Let's work it from this side. Okay, so that's looking nice. I'm just speaking out loud here. What's happening there? That's all right. I'll tell you what, we'll skip a little bit of gold. A little suggestion of gold there. That's nice. White open space. I'm liking that. So let's go in with the black. Let's spread the black a little bit down here. Now, what you don't know, folks, is that I can feel through the end of the wool mop, which actually isn't wool, it's made from synthetic, but you get the idea, that I can feel the way some of the paint is behaving. So instantly what that's saying to me is that some parts of it are wet. There'll be a few parts as I spread it out which will start to dry. So what I've really got to do now is be ultra super careful that I don't let things dry out too much, because if they dry out, then I'm not going to be able to move it to where I want it to be. So Deep Ashtray's got a good question, which AD's going to tell me now in my ears. So, good question from Deep Ashtray about popping air, blowing something with soap and making soap bubbles. Mixing the paint with soap bubbles and blowing air into it. Yeah, I suppose that's something we can add to the to-do list. I'm sure we can have a go. Never thought about that. I'm not really sure whether the enamel paint's going to start eating it alive, because it tends to eat most things. But it would be very, very interesting to have a go. So, I'll tell you what, we'll add that to the experiment list, and we'll report back at some point, let you know how we got on. How's that? That's a great question, so thank you for asking that. If anybody's got any burning questions, please do ask them. Okay, right, so you can see us now starting to build up some of what's going on, so that's good so far. I'm pretty happy with that. Still trying to A, cover some canvas, and B, preserve the integrity of the lines. So as with everything that goes through my head, there is method to it all, and there are reasons behind it. I'm just hopefully trying to explain as many of them as I can before I forget. Tanya Woodford is here! Where have you been? Where have you been, Tanya? Goodness me. Right, why is my laptop not working? Let's sort that out. There we go, now it is. Oh, Tim Burgess is here. Just watching with one eye in my studio. No, you should be paying full attention, Tim. This is unacceptable. Only joking. Okay, so that's cool. We'll come back and have a look at that in a second. Okay, loving it so far. The gold, I have to tell you guys, the gold is looking unbelievable. Now, I notice I'm a little bit light in the centre, and what I don't want to do is run the risk here, you can see that on the overhead, of it being separated into two pieces. So I just got to be careful about popping something here. So tell you what we'll do. Let's get rid of the thin line by my foot. We don't want that to cause a problem now, do we? Okay, I'm going to scoop up a little bit of black here. Let's just pop a little bit of definition there. Now, some of the ones that look like I've used this particular tool on them, I'm going to attack those with the thinners definitely next, because I don't want them to look too forced. Now, the paint is quite thin on these little applications, which is great, which means that the thinners is going to do its job fairly quickly. Right. So Loretta Leo says, is this one canvas, question mark? Yeah, there's no joins. Like me when I put my wig on, you can't see the join, tell you. Okay, moving on. That went down well. Okay. Right, so let's just cover a bit of that up. Right. Right, so bear with me a sec, guys. I've just got to adjust myself. Right, actually, me. Oh, let's get my shoelace done up. Now, I would like to remind everybody that we've shot a video and launched it last week, which had featured us doing a small acrylic painting. Yes, I know, acrylic paints. What is this, Ed? This wizardry with acrylic paints. Yes, well, went out and got some, and we shot a video because we want to try and get everybody to go creating and get the painting bug. So we released that video onto the channel, so please do go have a look after we finish the broadcast. Gonna have a little lots of fun. Anybody can have a go. Everybody's loving it. Got some really good feedback off people, and we've done a second one, and that will be coming out on Friday around about 4-5 p.m. GMT, so London time. All right, so please do have a look at that. If you're inspired to have a go, you will be absolutely staggered by what you can achieve with a few bits of card and some acrylic paint. Seriously, we've spent a lot of time filming them. We've had a huge amount of fun. So please do go and make sure you check those out when Fridays is released, and then hopefully we're going to have a look at the other one as and when. Right, okay, guys, so we've got a basic structure now. What we've been doing, so what have we been doing after 36 minutes? So we've got ourselves a nice even spread. We've got the black taken care of. We've got it coming in from both directions. The thinners is doing its job. We've helped spread it out a little bit. So now I'm going to fill up my jar and we're going to spray it. So let's see. I'm just going to fill this up and then we'll have a little look at the chat. So if anybody's got any questions, please feel free to ask. Now, I might sound as if I'm panting a little bit, or my breathing feels a bit laboured. I apologise for that, but it's very, very warm in here tonight. We've had about an 18, 19 degree day here at the studio outside, and with the nature of the building holding heat and also holding the cold, as soon as the sun's out, this place is literally like being inside an oven. So it's either a blast furnace in here or an ice palace. Today, it's definitely like a blast furnace. Okay. Right, so I'm pressurizing my container. Yeah, so anyway, sorry if I sound like I can't breathe. It's nothing sinister, I promise you. Okay. Right, so I'm gonna give this is standard thinners again. Look at that. Isn't that a beautiful thing? Look at my lovely sprayer. Mm-mm. It's like the floor. Great work of art. Anyway. Right, so I'm just going to go liberally. That's just a bit too. What's happening there? Let's have a look. That's it. Sort of missed her out. So here now, I'm just going to start and loosen everything up a little bit, especially the bits where I've thinned the paint out by moving them. So I'm going to give this a liberal spraying over the thinners. Very difficult to see on the gold, but the gold tends to spread itself out. Oh, Funny Fox is off. Goodbye, Funny Fox. Good night, everybody. Good night, George. Good night, everybody. Thank you so much for joining us. Yeah, stay safe, everybody. That's a good one. Okay, so we're here now. We've given this a bit of a spray. Liking that now. It's a proper dousing everywhere. And the nice thing about being flat on the floor is I can move all around a canvas in 360 degrees, which is always a good thing. Now then. Yeah, the work, it is Katerina, isn't it? It's a work of art, that sprayer. Okay, right. So Megan asks, what kind of sprayer is it? Let's have a look, shall we? That's a car sprayer. Well, actually, it says brake cleaner applicator, so it's designed to have brake cleaner in it. Now, the reason for that is, brake cleaner being quite a corrosive substance, it won't actually destroy all the seals inside here, and because thinners is a corrosive substance, it won't destroy the actual sprayer. So we've tried to match the nature of what's going in it to the actual product itself, so I hope that clears that up. Okay, so I'm just going to revisit the edges now, because my edges need a little bit of work. Back we go. Yeah, I was just saying, because I paint flat on the floor, I can just revisit this in 360 degrees, which is great. Okay, I think we're doing good, ladies and gents. I want to pop just the tiniest drop of black on. And I think I'm just going to pop a little soupçon just in the center here. That's it. And we'll just keep an eye on that particular one and make sure it moves, all right? In fact, I might give it a little douse now, because I don't want that to look like, stick out like a sore thumb. Okay, let's get that moving. Okay, that's fine. Right, let's have a, before I change the gloves, let's catch up on the chat, shall we? Okay, Grant Bailey is here. Hi, Grant, how you doing? What have we got? Okay. Tanya Woodford, hey Zane, how are you doing? That's good. Looking like a forest to me at the moment, and I enjoy watching it transform. Thank you very much, Damiana, that's kind of you. Deep Ash Dre has some nice depth to it. Yeah, actually it is looking pretty good, so thank you very much for that. Right, okay, so let's revisit where we're so tempting to roll this up, isn't it, and just put it on top of itself. Anyway, I'm not going to do that, don't worry. Right, so let's have a look on the chest cam. See if we can get a bit closer. We just hopefully start to see this starting to develop now, and some of the shapes are starting to go. Now, while we're on chest cam, if I point out, so here, where my finger is, this is raw canvas. It doesn't have any paint on the back. Now, when the paint hits, you get almost like a capillary effect, but only up to a certain point. And you only get that depending on how thick the paint is. So what I want to do is to try and thin it into these areas so it doesn't spread too much. But in other areas, I've done it where, let's see if we can find that, where it is starting to spread, perhaps like here. So these are the nice combinations that you can get by mixing, you know, what you do with the paint and what goes on, first of all, and of course how much thinners you put on. So that's interesting. You see what's happening here, are we still on the chest cam? So that was the single line I put on literally 2 or 3 minutes ago. Now you can see what that's doing, that's kind of delineating itself and spreading out. So it was kind of central point to the painting, that's looking really nice. And actually the textural elements and the tones are looking really nice as well. So yeah, I'm quite pleased with that at the moment. Now what I don't want it to... Oh, Swampy Anky Guitars is here. Good evening, Bill. How you doing? Nice to see you. You're late. So you're in detention, along with Tanya. Oh dear, your computer died. Not to worry. Okay. Right, so let me have a think now where I want to take this. So this is the crucial bit now where I just want to have a think about what I'm doing. Okay, let's have a think. So Derek asks, is there any look or feel that I'm trying to go for this piece? Well, yes and no really, Derek. I'm quite concerned that I want this kind of up and down thing going. But I don't necessarily want everything to meet in the middle, but I want certain areas to mix and other areas not to. Because I think it's just going to be this... I don't even know how to describe it. I can't call them stalactites and stalagmites, but I suppose it's a little bit what it is, really, you know? Now, at the moment, the only thing is I'm quite heavy on the gold. You know, particularly this seam here, this seam here. And I'm just thinking I don't want to lose the black areas, because that's the whole point. And some of them are starting to wash away now, so I've just got to be very, very super careful on whether I apply any more or not. Yeah, great name for me and Holmes, White Tiger Stripes. Yeah, I suppose it is really, isn't it? But yeah, to answer your question, Derek, this is all about line structures more than anything, but what I don't want them to be is rigid, firm or pre-planned. I want them to be a little bit organic, but at the same time I've still got to have that structure, if that kind of makes sense. I'm going to pop some more white on, I think. Cream's looking nice. I can definitely see that in areas. but I think I need to get a little bit busy with the white. So we're just going to go straight from the can now, folks, I think. Shall we? Should we just do that? Should we go straight from the can?
Do it! Just do it! Yesterday is set tomorrow, so just do it! Make your dreams come true! Nothing is impossible! No, what are you waiting for? Do it! Just do it! Yes, you can!
Right. Let's get some of these on. Now, can I get one? So we're on all cameras now. That's always a good shot. Let's see if I can do something down here. Now, if I put these in lines, this is going to add yet another textural element. Can you see what I'm doing now, hopefully, on the all-camera shot? So these lines, they'll delineate a little bit. But they should keep their shape, hopefully. Blimey, Derek, undulating rectilinear flow. I can't even pronounce that. But that's a good name, Derek. Thank you very much. Yes, it's easy for you to say, isn't it? Right, let's just get some of them. Right, okay, let's just get some of these in, especially where that is. Look, I just want to calm that down a little bit. Let's calm these golds down. So we're already banging this on now, which is great. Now I'm losing a little bit of black here and now, which is fine. Okay, so having done that, let's get the lid on. Definitely don't want any more cream. Now on the overhead, I can't stress how big this looks on the floor. When it's actually stretched around the frame, it's enormous. Right, okay. Rasmus Bray likes it, thank you. Footsteps China. Oh, where have you disappeared to? Oh, won't find me on Faceplant either. No idea what that means, but hey-ho. Zane Taylor, 3 weeks in lockdown. Okay, great, you guys are having fun. Nice. Okay. Right, I'm just going to go in with the tiny droplets of black just here and there. I've got to be careful now because I don't want to ruin it. One. This one's okay. Needs extending. Two. Let's pick a couple more of those out, I think, here. Let's take one up from that direction. That needs doing. That's pretty good. Let's get one up that way. Yeah, I like that. That's nice. Okay, I just felt like I wanted to add a little bit more structure to it. Okay, this is pretty good. So let's just check our stats.
Hey, that's pretty good.
Right, if I add some pink, I could call it Joe Exotic. Very topical, I like that. Okay, fine. Right, so, okay, good. Right, let me take a look. I'm just going to change my gloves, folks. Let me have a little look at that. Wayne Tully thinks it's looking great. Thank you, Wayne. That's very kind of you. Right. Don't forget, guys, if you're new here, please do give us a subscribe. Remember, you can follow us on all the social media, but yeah, you really help us out by subscribing. And remember, recommend us to your friends as soon as we get to 20,000 subs. We'll have two paintings to give away, not just one. I mean, can you believe that? Two. So sweaty I am. Look, I can't even get my gloves on. What? Look, call myself a professional. What is that all about? But yeah, so we're going to give two paintings away. So we've tried to give one away at 10,000 subscribers and tried three times and failed miserably. I think, yeah, we'll just give the two away at 20,000 subscribers. If you do know anyone that would benefit from watching the channel on a Wednesday, then that would be great. Remember, what is it, 3 or 4 weeks ago, bless Nikki. Nikki won the one in the corner, which you can probably see over there. I'm still safe there, Nikki, don't you worry. We're in some trying times at the moment, folks, but Nikki's painting is safe in the corner. So hopefully, we'll be videoing that as well, by the way. She's been very gracious and said we can film her when, I don't know what she's letting herself in for. When she comes to pick it up. So we're going to film that for you guys so you can see Nikki coming to pick it up, all right? So she's agreed to come to the studio, which I think is brilliant. Right. So, Stephen Morris is here. Good evening. What did he say? Monochromatic-tastic. Woo! That's pretty good. The reader says Golden Zebra. Sorry, Ed, don't mean to be plugging my page. Don't worry about it, Derek. You're absolutely fine. Plug in your page, get out of it. Go on. Disgusting. You disgust me, Derek. Go on. Sing your look, pal. Get out of here. How dare you? I'm joking. It's just for fun. Thank you, Derek. You're great. Okay, what else have we got? Kevin Kemble is here. He made it. Hello, Kevin. Nice to see you. Question. What effect does cold and humidity on enamel do for curing, if any, asks Zane. Very little, Zane. Because these, I'm just giving it another little dousing in a few places. Yeah, it doesn't do a lot, to be honest with you, Zane. It's just air, really, that matters, as they're air curing paints. So, you know, heat and light and humidity doesn't really make any difference, if I'm honest. The only reason, well, the extractor helps with airflow, but that doesn't really speed the drying time up significantly. But it does help, obviously, get all the nasty stuff out of the studio. Okay, so I'm not going to do any more top drops. That's a drop from the top, but I am going to pop a little bit on the thinners, just in a couple of places, and then I'm going to add the special sauce.
Yay!
Right, okay, this is good. This is what I wanted to do. I needed some more paint on before I could get the thinners on. Now, like I say, the last one I did similar to this, I did over three sessions, which is around about 2 hours each. So I'm trying to sort of compensate for that at the moment by chemically inducing some of the effects that I would have got by doing them manually with just time and patience. So a little bit of it, not as forced, but I am starting to do a couple of unusual things which I think just need to be done. So now I'm really going for a big, can you see that? That's a huge volume I'm pouring on there. This is a lot of thinners going on, guys. So the hope is I can just coax some of these forms into really starting to move. I think certainly on the replay, if you were to come back and then when you see how this will start to develop, you'll appreciate just what I mean by that. Yeah. Have a look. Let's go back around here for a second. Yeah. Okay, let's do something here, I think. Scoop a bit of that up. Alright, I need to work on this line here, guys. Let's get a drop. I think we'll get a drop of black in there. Just a little scoop and we'll bring it to the end so that we can balance that up. So this is the nice thing about being able to see what we're doing. I'm just going to have a look on the overhead in just a second. Yeah, okay, I know what I need to do. I know what I need to do there. That's fine. So let's get some of that on. And so the benefit of having four cameras, you can go and have a look at what you're doing, which is good. Okay, you do need to on a large canvas. You've got to be able to step back and try and figure out what on earth is going on. You know, with these large surface areas, it can be really difficult. Okay, that's fine. We'll do the same thing again. We'll get that worked on. And then, oh, now the fun's going to start. We're going to finish off. I'm going to have to turn this. I'm going to have to turn it 90 degrees. So Lord knows how I'm going to do that. But we're going to do it. We're definitely going to do it. You might see AD in just a second, because I think he's going to come in and help me turn it as well. So, Suarez 57 is a great name for special sauce. Yes, I agree. Okay, right. So, just going to give that a little squeeze of the special sauce. One there, one there.
Yay!
One there, one there. This has a wonderful selling property to it. If you've never seen it, this is a combination of four different chemicals, none of which I'm going to tell you what they are. I think that's probably it for spraying now. Right, I'll tell you what, let's do one squirt in the centre and I'll do this on chest cam so you can see what happens. So let's move around here and then I think we're going to try and move it, and I'll explain why we're going to move it in just a second. Right, okay, I'm going to go here. So I'll just check with AD, can we see that? Are we ready? Woo! All right. Look at all that go. Nice. Okay, yeah, so let me explain just as, before Eddie comes in, why I'm going to turn it. Now, if you can see on chest cam, can you see sort of that sort of in front of me there? It's all moving this way. I don't want it to move this way, I want it to move down. And the reason for that is I've got a very, very slight slope in the floor. Oh no, we've tried to fix it. So I'm just going to turn it because I need it to maintain its line integrity. So Eddie's going to leave on corner cam and he's going to join me now. So you can welcome the legend. That is Adrian. He's coming in to help me when he's got his mask on. And we're going to try and turn that round between us. It should be good for a laugh. This is where it normally goes completely wrong. But I don't care. Okay, right, so, yeah, I'm hoping when we turn it that I'm all this is going to start sort of figuring itself out up and down. So, because that's starting to move and I don't want it to move too bad, so we need it to get going the other way. So this is going to mess it up on the overhead cam, but here he is! Of course, he can't hear me. Right, I'm going to talk to him now.
So which way you
want to rotate? Yeah, there he is! To rotate it this way,
yeah.
So that, yeah, so this comes round here, and that one round there, buddy, all right? So again? Hopefully, yes. Yeah. Right, I think that's, we can understand each other. Oh no, what's going on? Right, this is going well. All right, I got it. Do you want to get outside, mate? Right. Hang on. I said this was going well, didn't I? That's all right. No. I got it. It's like the Muppets, this, isn't it? Okay. Oh, good Lord. Right. There. I can sort that. I got it. Yeah, it's good, mate. Oh, good Lord. Right. Well, that wasn't stressful, was it? At all, that wasn't stressful. Now, I've got to be so careful. Not to, but there's so much thinners on there. Yeah, that's good, mate. Yeah, sorry. Sorry, I couldn't hear you. Yeah, that's cool, mate. Yeah. Oh. Just give me a second. That was quite intense. Okay. All good. Right, I'm going to straighten that up. I've got to be so careful I don't slide over on this. Oh, lordy, lordy. Right, it's just zipping everything up. Okay. He's back in control. I think he deserves a round of applause. Thank you, Eddie, legend. Round of applause. Right, so I've got to straighten this up and try and get all the kinks out of it, and I'm not making a reference to Ray Davis here either. Oh my Lord. Hey, you don't get this on Netflix, do you? I knew I should have left it where it was. No, I'm only joking. Okay, so all I've got to do now, folks, is try and make sure I haven't got too many ridges in. I don't mind them going this way, because they'll help to structure the lines. It's the other way, I don't need them. I don't want ridges that way. Good Lord. Stephen, no naughty words, please. Keep it clean for our younger viewers, if you don't mind, please. Thank you. You can say holy shirt or holy Shiraz or something like that. That's all good, my friend, so if you don't mind. Okay, brilliant. Right, so, having now achieved the impossible, courtesy of my learned friend, we can have a look now, see which way this is all going now. I'm hopeful because I know which way the floor slopes. Oh, I got up too quick. Hang on. It should start behaving itself now and sort of coming this way a little bit. That's the general plan anyway. Right, okay, so yeah, this is good. Now I'm going to point out, so can we see, I don't know if we can see this even on the overhead or wherever, but just here, it's all starting to come this way. Awesome. And we start to get some of the black and the white mixing. Double awesome. Now we're getting the rivers from here flowing this way. Triple awesome. Oh god, what comes after triple? I can't remember. Quadruple. Here, yeah, this is all starting to move. Now the only thing that is concerning is if it stops. So I think to finish off there'll be a few areas which I might just need to turn to just to coax them sort of in the more up and down. But these are starting to work, that's starting to work, this is going gorgeous, it's all flowing downhill. So is the rivers here. Happy days on a I don't know what I was gonna say. Anyway, happy days. On a happy day. Happy days on a happy day, there you go. So here, yeah, pretty good. Let's move the gold down a little bit. I'm gonna have one. Dear Deepash, yeah, I've poked myself into a corner. Oh, tee hee. Lols. Does feel like that. Oh, don't be honest, I think it looks like clouds. Even better. Nice. Right, we're just gonna drop a few little soupçons of paint here and there. I just wanna maybe extend some of these black applications up and down just a little bit. There we go, I'm quite happy with that. Now they probably do look a bit like rainfall or, you know, storm clouds or something. It's quite a stormy kind of piece, isn't it? But that's good, I like that. Let's get a bit of drama going. That's what we want for a Wednesday evening, Suarez HQ. What is life without a little drama, eh, my friends? Okay, happy with that, happy days. That one's looking quite nice as is, but I'm going to scoop up just the tiniest bit of black. And then we will have just enough time just to do a few more shout outs. Oh, Megan Michael says golden tears. That's very profound, isn't it? Hey, good job you didn't say the other one then, Megan. Save that for another day. Right, move on, Ed. I'll get me coat. Right, okay, like that. Like that a lot, folks. That's this is going to look, when this is all cured and we post the pictures of it, which we'll try and do as soon as quick as possible, this is going to be proper sensational, this one. I'm very excited about that. Right, I've got just one or two key areas I'm going to give a last hurrah to. Whereabouts, that's moving, that isn't, so get that done. Now don't forget, we put our special sauce on, so we're going to activate all these amazing cells. So it's going to look stunning. Oh, no, I can see the way it's going now. Wowzers, is just going to look mind-blowing when it's all finished curing and moving. Right then, let's have a final look, my beautiful friends, if I can get past this without falling onto my derriere. Let's just get a lid on the can there. Okay, can he? Let's do this. Oh, okay, nearly went. Oh, my what's happened to my computer? Oh, there we go. Which camera are we on, buddy? Okay, right, let's have a final shout out. So, Derek, my apologies for misunderstanding. Oh, he's contacting Stephen, that's fine. Flow Motion Head Rush. Whoa, Ian Holmes, have you eaten a thesaurus? That's brilliant. Flow Motion Head Rush. Right, can I just write that down? Flow Motion Head Rush. I think that's what I got when we moved it around 90 degrees. Tanya says it looks stunning. Thank you. Michelle says golden storm. Zane Taylor's full of laughy emojis. Damiana Herrera loves it. Thank you so much. Megan Michael, yes, careful. Derek Van Dusen says it's gorgeous. Thank you so much. Tanya says it looks stunning. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, your feedback is amazing. I'm glad I haven't fallen over and split the difference. Let's just do one chest cam view. Let's see if I can get down here a little bit. Right, can we see that? look at those cells coming, and the rivers are starting to move, and it's really starting to take quite a tone onto itself now. This is absolutely going to look stunning when it's done. I can just feel it. Yeah, okay. Thanks, guys. Just wanted to give you a final with a look at that. Denise Weeks likes it. Thank you, Denise. The Rita likes it. Take it, mon ami, says Ian. Thank you very much. Thomas Johnson says awesome. Stephen Morris loves it. Zane Taylor loves it. Guys, you're the best. Can I have a piece of your floor, says Derek. Yeah, all major credit cards accepted, Derek. No problem. Okay, guys, thank you so much for watching this evening. If you've been new here, I hope you've enjoyed it. Don't forget, if you are new, give us a subscribe. I know we keep saying it, but it really helps us out here, guys. It's so, so important. Please share the love. The more people we can get to watch the streams, the better, the more fun we have. You're amazing coming back every single week, and if this has been your first time, I do hope you've enjoyed it. We'll try and keep the themes going every week and do something a little bit more creative and a bit unusual every week as much as we can. We've got loads of live streams you can go back and have a look at, so if you are stuck indoors, I've hopefully got you plenty of entertainment for you. And don't forget, on Friday we've got the new do-it-yourself acrylic painting video coming out, which is brilliant! It has to be, we spent 9 hours editing it yesterday. Anyway, thank you so much, everybody. It's been an absolute pleasure. And if my mum's still watching, thank you so much. I hope I haven't bored you to tears. Right, it only leaves me on behalf of myself and Adrian to say thank you so much for watching. You guys have been amazing as always. We'll be here next Wednesday, same time. We'll be doing something completely different, no doubt. Please run and tell all of your friends. And from us both, we of course do wish you the very best of health. Please stay well. We'll all look forward to seeing you next week.